on a time. Childless baker. With his wife.
More than love. The king is giving a festival. I wish to go to the festival. And the moon. I wish to go to the festival. I wish. You wish to go.
The poor girl's mother had died.
The festival, the king's festival.
And her father had taken for his new wife.
The festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
It's your nails.
It's your dress. Take all of
that. Just you wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father and his mother.
I wish.
Well, she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish the house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child, what in heaven's name are you doing with the cow inside of the house?
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them up in 2 hours' time, you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun or four.
Oh!
times when he was. He was eager to have a family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed. Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
Then what do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now he's there.
The witch told the couple that she had placed a spell on their house. What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife with you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was a child. She developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, nothing but greens, parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fennel, ferns, and lettuce. She said, all right, but it wasn't right, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was mobbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, and ripping up my raffia, my champion, my favorite eyes. She laid a spell on him right there. I could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair. I got to spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You could let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it square.
I had a brother.
No. But you had a sister.
The witch refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother had warned me I would be punished if I were to ever lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall and then bang, crash, the lightning crashed. Well, that's another story. Never mind anyway. Let the big day came. I made my claim. Oh, don't take away the baby. They shrieked and screeched, but I did. And I hit her where she'll never be reached. Your father cried. Your father died. When her extra that your family tree would always be a barren one. So there's no more fuss and there's no more seeds in my garden. Thrice you should see my nectarines. But I'm telling you this, same I tell kings and queens. Don't you ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
Listen well, son. Leave Milky Way to market and fetch the best price you can. Less than 5 pounds. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now how much are you to ask?
No more than 5 pounds.
Less than 5.
Of midnight in 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee,
I found Father's hunting jacket?
Beans?
I wonder if that...
The witch's meat! We'll take them with us!
No, you are not coming!
I know you are fearful of the woods at night.
No, no, the spells are my house. Only I can lift the spell. The spells
no,
are my house.
On our house.
No,
we must
no,
lift the spells.
You're not coming
again
to find
me.
Now, what am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the king is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the silver is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the baker reluctantly set off to meet the enchantress's demand. The silver is pure as gold. As for Cinderella,
resting.
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds.
Oh, now, Jack, why such a sum?
My mother
your
said...
Your mother? A boy your age? Why, you'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Well, I... Hello? Come look, you white, till there are spirits here.
Well, I seem to have lost my way. And what are you planning to do
there? Oh, and what are you planning to do there?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds?
Where am I to get 5 pounds?
She must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you don't fetch that sum, then what are you going to do?
Well, I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is a sum total.
Beans? Beans? We mustn't give up our beans! Well, if you feel we must.
What?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans, son. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him!
Magic that defies description.
My mother would... How many beans?
Six.
5. We can't part with them all. We have to keep one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say these beans are worth 1 pound each at the very least.
Do you think I could buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly. Good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
Take the cow and go home.
I was just trying to be helpful.
Magic beans. We have no reason to believe they're magic. Are we going to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one could have given him more for this creature. We did him a favor. At least they'll have some food to eat.
5 beans.
Then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. Maybe they're really magic. Who knows? I can do what you do. That's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her. She's crying.
All you do is pure in intent. If it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is my size.
What?
Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. Once the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beans.
I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so, the baker continued on his search for the paper's red as blood. As for Rapunzel, which was careful not to let this beauty into the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest.
Yeah.
Rapunzel? Rapunzel? What a strange name. Well, strange but beautiful and fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I'll stand beneath her window and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello there, little one.
Hello.
Have you saved any of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets and half the loaf of bread.
Ah. Where did you get that beautiful cape? I do so admire it.
My granny made it for me.
Is that right? I would love to have a cape just like that.
You look pretty foolish.
May I take a look?
Oh, I don't like to be without my cape. Please give it back.
I want it badly.
Give it back, please!
Forget the little girl and get the cape.
Now you get to your granny's and make sure no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day!
Ow! If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak, what's a cloak? Just a joke, just a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it, so you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them for.
And so, the baker, with newfound determination, continued on his search for the red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to see her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, Grandmother. Oh, my Grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
What to hear you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what big eyes you have.
What to see you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what large hands you have.
What to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, Grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have.
The bear ate you with.
Said this, he was devouring the little girl. It was a full day of eating for both. And with the wolf's appetite appeased, he took for a nice, long nap.
Huh. That grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd. Where's the little one? Eating, no doubt. We're eating! Grandmother, huh? What is that red cloth hanging from your mouth? It looks to me like one. That's it. I'll get the cape from within your stomach!
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Excited and scared.
bit not.
Are you searching?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me another with the skins of that wolf.
Thank you. Thank you.
And so the baker, with both articles in hand, feeling braver and more fulfilled than he had ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack...
Only a jolt would exchange a cow for beans.
Mother, no.
To bed with no supper for you.
Little did they know that those beans would grow to an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Are you all right, Miss?
Yes. I just need to catch my breath.
What a beautiful gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Aren't you the lucky one? Whatever are you doing in the woods at this hour?
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown, Master?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see over there.
Never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
Well, what brings you here, and with a cow? Oh, my husband's somewhere in the woods. He's undoing a spell.
Oh,
yes. Now the prince, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
And
it's a very nice ball.
And
when I answered, they trumped.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
He's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming. Yes.
And he made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
He is charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes?
I don't need a wide range. It's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow's eve?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? Oh, to be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
To get, the better to have. Three,
dear, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest. And she draws you close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew. Only just when you made a friend and all that you know she's big but you don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you miss all the things you know in the world you left and the little you own. The fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look low up in the world you know.
Wait, are you saying you wish more money?
I want more money.
Stay here, I'll fetch more.
No, wait, I... 5 gold pieces. With this, I could buy new baking supplies for a year. Or a new chimney. Or a new Dutch roof.
Could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. When explained, I'm nothing serious. Could you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces. 10, 20.
I have not thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. You've not thought about many things, have you? Son.
Hey, give that back! That's not yours!
Nor is it, Jax. The money's not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
Hey! Come back here! Damn, hey! What are you doing here?
I see you have the red cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 items left to locate.
Two,
I have the cape and the cow.
You've the cape?
What have you done to the cow?
She ran away. I never returned home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to entrust her to you.
She might just have easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't.
Who cares? The cow is gone. Get it back, get it back.
Yes. We were just about to do that. Here, we can give you this.
Don't give me that, you fool. I don't want to touch that for sense. By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the eggs with the wish you never thought to have a child.
Oh! I really don't like that woman!
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
No. I shouldn't have yelled. No, please, go back to the village. But listen, I will make things right, and then we can just go about our lives. No more searching for strange objects in the woods, no more witches, no more dim-witted boys or hungry little girls. Now go.
Oh, there you are, good brother. Father and I have wondered where you had gone.
I've been looking all night.
For her. Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared like a fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
Well, I'm not so certain of that, I must confess. I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, at the top of a tall tower with no doors or stairs.
What?
Oh, 2 weeks from here, 2 weeks just beyond the Mossimo.
And how do you manage to visit?
Well, I stand beneath her tower and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lets down the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn. Which I find her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel. What kind of name is that? You jest! I have never heard of such a thing.
Well, I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has.
Did I accuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, shall I regain the heart she has won for me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her aim. By the becoming and frequently humming, light-hearted air. If there only were doors.
Agony, oh, the torture they teach.
What's as intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her.
Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack!
on, Milky Light.
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see your wishes granted.
You've caused enough trouble. Keep out of my path.
You're thriving. There's something about the world.
but then once you've begun, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware.
Understand.
enough.
Here's a magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean? Nonsense!
Don't do that!
I've already given up one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
Wait! I needed to have a child.
That makes no sense.
Does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
No!
Here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I don't know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing.
Let the cow!
And I have the slipper. We roll four.
I will give this to the prince. No. And we will search the kingdom tomorrow for a maiden who will fit this.
Give it back. I don't care if it costs me my life.
Give her the slipper, and all will come to a happy
end. What was that noise?
Sir, it's just a bolt of lightning in a far off kingdom.
How dare you take off and search without me?
I apologize, sir. I just thought I might.
Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant.
I thought so. It did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
Sir, I've succeeded in finding the other slipper.
Give them the slipper, and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious.
Shut up!
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Pull it from the ear. Feed it to the cow. Quickly!
Business had better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
Please, not now.
Yes, it's your father.
Father? Is that you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run away from you, son, but...
Twinkie!
She's milking!
I don't understand.
Not now, into the cup!
Alright. We giving you what you wish?
Son!
When can we expect a child?
Son!
My father!
Oh!
Returned home. The witch, who was cursed with age and ugliness that night, when her beans were stolen and the lightning flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, he began his search to find the maiden. And when he arrived at Cinderella's home, the stepmother took the shoe into Florinda's room.
Mother?
who I truly am. Come with me, child. We can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with you.
Let her speak for herself. You are the only family I know. Come with me. You and those beautiful babies. Please.
As is often in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her power over others. When the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda joined, hoping to win in favor of Cinderella and share in her good fortune. But as the two stood by the couple, pigeons swooped down upon them and poked out their eyes, punishing them with blindness.
I see you, Princess. Found you?
Yes.
Able for the supper?
We're certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after.
Ever after!
Journey over, all is mended. And it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended. Ever after.
Ever after!
All the curses have been ended. Every curse is wiped away. All the tenderness and laughter will forever after.
Happy hours, happy answers, happy ever after.
There were dangers, right, and huge on the end, and the paths would often swerve.
Not a conceivable objection.
my father's house, and now I'll meet my son's.
She would raise your child alongside a witch.
Why does he always cry when I fall?
Babies cry. He's fine. You needn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
He wants his mother here.
I can't take care of him all the time.
I will take care of him when he's older.
Mother, I'm a man now.
There's still a little boy in your mother's eyes.
you to the wood today?
I'm investigating news of a giant.
You? Investigating news of a giant? Why, not even Father would do that. That's business for your steward. Or less?
Well, what brings you into the woods?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She's been subject to hysterical fits of crying in moods that no soul can predict. You see, I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Good brother, do tell me. What are you really doing here?
I, in a tower like yours, was but higher, a beauteous sleep. All round the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable. What unmistakable agony is the way always marked. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard. Something asleep.
If it were not for the thicket.
A thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick. It's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarves? Dwarves! Dwarves are very upsetting.
Not forgetting the tests unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable.
Agony, woe not to know what you miss.
While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their beards, what a
family.
What brings you to the woods?
The castle has been set upon by a giant!
No.
I warned you! Why didn't you do anything?
It'll make policy, I carry it out.
And I'm one of the royal family to solve your problems.
I feel it's best we all just go back to the village.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle?
No.
All that's left of my garden is a sack of wheat. There's not much left of my house.
But I heard giants never strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
He was your responsibility. Now I must punish.
the tower!
That's true! Yes!
If he is not, I will return and find you!
Rapunzel!
Don't step on!
She's in poor condition.
Wake up. Please don't let them hurt Jack.
I'll do all that I can.
Promise me you won't let him be hurt as I stand here on death's door.
I promise.
No, come away from there. You killed her!
I was thinking of the greater good, that's my job!
I do not want would she warn me about the woods?
You would leave our child with her.
He's sleeping. We'll be fine with the girl.
But what if the giants were to return here?
The giants will not harm them. I know.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if
But what if? Will only giant's foot stop your arguing?
You will stay here with the baby. Please.
Do you two always argue like that?
No, not really. Seems like you do. And there's nothing wrong with having an argument.
Oh, I see.
Milky!
Milky!
Jack! That's him! Jack! Jack!
Milky!
You stay here with the baby.
But I want to come!
No, you'll be safer here.
Oh, don't go too far, please.
I've only walked 100 paces, and if I don't find the lad, I'll come right back.
Seducing some young maiden.
What?
Well, I understand that's what some princes do.
Not all princes.
You kind of look like the princess, but dirty.
You are the princess!
No! Get up! I'm not a princess here!
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
You haven't heard? We came upon the royal family. The castle's been set upon by a giant.
And the prince?
He was not with them. You must come with me. You will be much safer in our company.
I must leave you.
Why?
The giant.
It's a giant. I had almost forgotten. Will we find each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. Our moment, shimmering and lovely and sad. Believe the moments, just be glad for the moments that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must be out to slay the giants. That is what the next moment holds for me. I will not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods. How alive you have made me feel.
What was that?
Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me, and kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not beseeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband. No one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are means, there are standards, there are shoulds and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're glad. It's these woods. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or that's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were made of moments, then you'll never know you had one. First a witch, then a giant, then a prince, then a moment. Who can live in the woods? You wish only just for a moment. These are dangerous words. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to war makes the ore mean more than it did before. Now I understand. Leave the world.
No, no. I should go look for her. In which direction did she go?
Ow! Look who I found!
To deliver me to the giant!
It's not our fault that the giant wants you.
You're hurting me!
Let go of him! Leave him alone!
Where did you find this? Where is my wife?
She's dead.
What? I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her. She was under a tree.
He was crying over her like she was his own mother.
How awful.
How could I let this have happened? I buried her in a footprint. What was I thinking? I should have just stayed with her.
Force will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now it's time to get this boy to the giant before we're all so much as dead people.
No, keep away from him! No!
This is no time to be soft-hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking him.
Yes. He's the one to blame. It's because of him there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead!
Well, it is my fault I was given those beans who persuaded me to trade in with Macau for beans, and without those beans, it'd have been no stock to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a light as old, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? What would tell us who persuaded you to steal that gold?
See, it's your fault!
No, so it's your fault!
Oh, yes, it is!
It's not! It's true!
Wait a minute, though, I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you!
So it's your fault!
Yes, no, it isn't. I've had those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's his father's fault that the curse got placed in the place, got cursed in the first place!
Oh, then it's his fault!
No.
It was his fault!
No, yes, it is, it's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, though, I chopped down the beanstalk, right? That's clear, but without any beanstalk, then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place?
Yes, how?
Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean?
The other bean?
Walking in the other bean?
I did, yes, it did.
So it's yours!
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's hers!
No, it isn't!
Whose is it?
Wait a minute, she exchanged that bean to obtain your shoes, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you!
You mean that old bean that your wife owed here, but I never knew it, so I threw it. Don't look here!
So it's your fault, what?
Because it's her fault.
She did it!
It isn't mine at all!
What? Well, if you hadn't gone that mob again, you would read, did you need that head?
Well, I got it from my mother.
So it's her fault then!
Yes, and what about the harm in the fireplace?
The harm, yes, she would have dared to do it.
I dared you to?
Every dirty shadow is scared to
see.
Scared me!
No, I didn't!
So it's your fault!
Wait a minute! You had to dare to? Well, if you hadn't thrown away the bean in the fireplace, she had to bring it to the fireplace!
How did you bring the bean
in the first place?
It's your fault!
You're all liars and thieves like his father.
making you rich. Let the hand thanks soar. Here you want some more. Listen to the roar. Giants by the score. Oh, well, you can blame another.
Where are we ever to go? like father, like son.
No more giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happier day arrives and we ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the woes, all the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses. All the wondering what even worse is still in store. All the children, all the giants.
Leave.
But I do love you.
Consider that I've been lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream, but now I wish for something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I the faraway prince. They're almost finished. You see up there between those two trees? When the giant comes, we are to send her over there.
Good. I wanted to climb the tower too.
Well, I'm glad you're here to help me.
What's wrong?
The granny's gone.
Oh no, I'm so sorry. I think my granny and my mother would be upset with me.
Why? They said to always make them proud. And here I am about to kill somebody.
Not somebody. A giant who's been doing harm.
But the giant's a person. Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very unhappy with these circumstances.
Mother cannot guide you.
I've slain the giant.
Oh, Jack, your mother, she's dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
Well, she was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you. And then she was struck a deadly blow by the prince's steward.
Why would he do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back? That steward will pay for this. Once I've slain the giant, I will slay him!
You will do no such thing.
But he shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
I guess not.
Then he must die.
Well, no.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
What he did was wrong. He should be punished.
He will be, somehow.
How?
I don't know. Would you stop asking me questions? I can't answer!
I'm going to kill him.
Then kill him! No. Don't kill him.
But you are not alone.
Thank you.
sad young lad.
This has been a presentation of WRAM-TV.